I'm going to show you guys a side dish. A lot of times, vegetarians, vegans always ask me what other vegetable they can use. I'm going to introduce you guys to a parsnip. This is a parsnip with like a carrot, but it's like a mix between a carrot and some parsley. And this is what it looks like before it's peeled. This is what it looks like after it's peeled. So I'm going to do parsnip, carrot, and plantain as a side dish. It's just good to have like a new spin on everyday ingredients. So this is going to be sesame, ginger, plantain, carrot, and parsnip. So I have a little bit of olive oil in my pan. It's on number 10. Got a little smoke coming from it. So I'm going to put the plantain in first. I put these in the freezer. I just wanted to make sure that they stay pretty fresh. So I had them in the freezer a while back. I do a rough cut on the parsnip. So it's fairly easy to cut, it cuts just like a carrot. I'm gonna cut it about the same size as the plantain, so it can all generally cook at the same time. Make sure you guys subscribe to my page. Let me know what you guys think of these recipes and whether you have something that you want me to try. I have a lot of recipes that I'm going to get ready to show you guys over the next few weeks. I'm super, super, super excited. I'm going to add the parsnip. I'm going to season it at this stage. So I have a similar house mix. The only thing I did to change it up a little bit was add some ginger. I'm going to do a rough cut on the carrots. I'm going to do what we like to call an oblique cut on the carrots, just to give it a little bit more dimension. I usually try to have everything ready for you guys when I do a video, but sometimes I like to let you guys know from start to finish, some of these dishes don't take a long time. So this is about 2 carrots and 1 whole parsnip. Forget that. See, my plantain is getting a little too brown. Plantain has a lot of sugar, so definitely be careful and make sure you get a nice amount of movement on it. If your pan looks a little dry, go ahead and add another tablespoon of oil. I'd rather add than have it drowning the oil at the end. Seasoning. So as far as my garnish, I have a little bit of candied ginger. I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. And I have some scallions, my candied ginger. I'm just going to slice it up in a julienne. I have some scallions. And last week, I showed you guys how to roast garlic. I roasted some more this week. So I have some roasted garlic, so I'm going to add that in at the end. It becomes like nice and sweet. I like it. And when I'm making the glaze for this, since I said sesame ginger, so I have soy sauce, sesame oil, fish sauce, and my little secret ingredient. It's called rice seasoning. I really have no idea what it says since it's in Korean, Japanese. I'm not quite sure, and I don't want to offend anybody, but I'm going to add that too. also have a little bit of black and white sesame seed. I let the root veggies go for about 2 or 3 minutes. So now I'm gonna add my little bit of stuff to make a sauce. I have about a tablespoon of brown sugar. Because you have to add a little bit of sweetness since you're adding soy sauce and fish sauce, which both are very salty. Yeah, a couple of tablespoons of soy sauce. A splash of fish sauce. I'm going to add my herbs. I'm using the same ones. So I have a little bit of marjoram. See how fast it reduced down? It's gonna reduce it and become like a little bit of a thick syrupy glaze. Definitely gotta taste it at this stage to make sure that it's not too salty, because soy sauce and fish sauce can be salty. Yep, it is a little bit salty. I'm gonna add the rest of the sugar. I'm going to add my few cloves of roasted garlic. It's just about ready, so I'm going to get me a spoon so I can clean it up. And there we go. We have a really, really, really easy, quick side dish. I have parsnips, carrots, and plantain, all sauteed with a little bit of soy sauce and fish sauce and brown sugar. Now I'm gonna plate it up for you guys. Make sure you guys use plastic on your non-stick pans or use wood. Don't, you know, mess it up. Want it to last a long time, especially because sometimes they're rather expensive. So you don't want to tear it up before you get your full value out of it. So that's what it looks like. You want to add the rest of the glaze. I'm gonna add the sesame seeds, black and white. And I'm gonna do a rough chop on some scallions. And the rough chop just means no particular size at all. So I got my scallions on. And I told you guys I was gonna do a little bit of crystallized ginger. So I'm going to do a small, small dice on that. And that's my side dish. You got carrot, parsnip, and plantain glazed with soy sauce and sesame oil. Oh, I forgot to add my sesame oil. I don't like to cook it because it just kind of loses all its flavor. I use it as a finishing oil. Garnished with crystallized ginger, scallions, and red and black sesame seeds. Let me know what you guys think. You should try it out. Once you try it out, you know, let me know. Click the subscribe button on the Urban Palette with Chef Mercy. Let me know, is there anything that you want me to try? And I'll see you guys next time.